Hi, this is Dr. B. Let's do the Lewis structure for the cyanide ion. We know it's an ion because it has a charge up here. In this case, it's a negative charge, so it's an anion. Let's count the valence electrons. On the periodic table, carbon's in group 4, sometimes called 14, and nitrogen is in group 5, right next to it, so it has 5 valence electrons. And this negative means we have an extra valence electron to work with, so let's add that in there. We have a total of 10 valence electrons to work with. So let's draw our carbon and our nitrogen right here, and let's take and put the electrons around. Let's do a bond first. So there's 2 electrons. Now we've bonded the carbon and nitrogen together. We've used 2. Let's put them around here. 4, 6, 8, 10, and we can check for octets. Nitrogen's fine, it has 8 valence electrons. Carbon only has 4. So let's take and move these electrons right here. Let's put them in the center. And now, carbon has 6, that's better. And nitrogen, it still has 8, 2, 4, 6, 8. So it's sharing and it keeps those 8. Let's put 2 more in there and see what happens. Nitrogen, 2, 4, 6, 8. Carbon also has 8. So that's the valence structure for CN minus, the cyanide ion. We'll clean this up a little bit. You could also write it in a structural formula, and that would look just like this right here, where your 3 pairs of electrons are represented by 3 straight lines. This is Dr. B, and thanks for watching.